Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video we are going to discuss general knowledge questions as well as last 6 months current affairs questions. So these GK questions and current affairs questions will be most importantly useful for AIIMS students as well as to all the students who are going to appear for their competitive exams. So first let's begin our video with general knowledge questions and later we'll go through the last 6 months current affairs questions. So let's begin our video with GK questions. First GK question is, which planet is called the green planet? Your options are Uranus, Earth, Saturn, Mars. I'm repeating the question as well as options. Which planet is called as a green planet? Your options are Uranus, Earth, Saturn and Mars. Okay, so if you want to take time for thinking the answer, you can pause the video, think and then play the video. But now I'm revealing the answer. The answer is option A, Uranus. Okay, so coming to next question, why is the Earth known as blue planet? Options are due to presence of water, due to presence of green plants, due to presence of air, due to presence of living organisms. I'm repeating the question. Why is the Earth known as blue planet? Due to presence of water, due to presence of air, due to presence of green plants and due to presence of living organisms. Correct answer is due to the presence of water. Earth is known as blue planet. Okay, because blue is the symbol, like the symbolic color for water. Okay, so coming to next question, who among the following was the first female pilot in Indian Air Force? Okay, I'm repeating the question. Who among the first female pilot in Indian Air Force? Okay, options are Jan Levitt, Avani Chaturvedi, Avani Singh. These are the three options. First option is Jan Levitt, second option is Avani Chaturvedi, third option is Avani Singh, and the correct answer is option B, Avani Chaturvedi. Okay, and coming to next question, former Chief Justice of India R.M. Lodha is associated with which examinations launched under Medical Council of India? I'm repeating the question. Former Chief Justice of India R.M. Lodha is associated with which of the following examinations launched under Medical Council of India? There are three options. So coming to the options, first option is IIT JEE, NET, NEET. Okay, these are the three options. First option is IIT JEE, second option is NET, third option is NEET, NEET. Okay, so the correct answer is option C, NEET, NEET, NEET. Okay, so NEET is the exam which is associated with the R.M. Lodha, Chief Justice of India. Okay, which was launched under Medical Council of India. Okay, so coming to next question, Kangana Ranaut won which of the following awards in the year 2016 under the category of Women of the Year? Kangana Ranaut won which award as the category of Women of the Year in the year 2016? Options are option A, CNN IBN Indian of Year, option B, National Film Awards, option C, GQ Men of the Year Award, option D, Zee Cine Award. I'm repeating the options. CNN IBN Indian of the Year, National Film Awards, GQ Men of the Year Award, Zee Cine Award. Okay, so the correct answer is option C, GQ Men of the Year Award. Okay, so in the year 2016, Kangana Ranaut won GQ Men of the Year Award. Okay, so the next question is, the bullet train proposed by Ministry of Railways is to be started by 2018 between which cities? I'm repeating the question. The bullet train proposed by Ministry of Railways is to be started by 2018 between which of the following cities? Options are Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Chennai, Mumbai, Mumbai, Ahmedabad, Mumbai, Hyderabad. I'm repeating the options. Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Chennai, Mumbai, Mumbai, Ahmedabad, Mumbai, Bangalore. And the correct answer is option C, Mumbai and Ahmedabad. That is, the bullet train proposed by the Ministry of Railways is being launched between the cities Mumbai and Ahmedabad. Okay, so coming to next question, what was the theme of the 2016 Rio Olympics? What was the theme of 2016 Rio Olympics? Options are peace for inner soul, live sports, live freedom, nothing can be achieved without peace, world peace and environment. I'm repeating the options. Peace for inner soul, live sports, live freedom, nothing can be achieved without peace, world peace and environment. And the correct option is option D, world peace and environment. Okay, so world peace and environment was the main theme of the 2016 Rio Olympics. Okay, so these kind of GK questions will be very important, like, you know, they will be most frequently asked in AIIMS and almost in every competitive exam. Okay, so coming to next question, which of the following vehicle does not include the use of petrol? I'm repeating the question. Which of the following vehicle does not use the petrol, like does not include the use of petrol? The options are car, scooter, bicycle, jeep. Car, scooter, bicycle, jeep. Okay, so cars, this is very 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 easy answer, like question. Cars use petrol, scooters can't run without petrol, jeep can't run without petrol. So the remaining option is bicycle. Bicycle does not require petrol. Okay, so this kind of logics you need to use while solving GK questions. Okay, who among the following became the chief executive officer of Google in the year 2015? Okay, so who among these options became the CEO of Google in the year 2015? Okay, the options are Sundar Khan, Sundar Pichai, Satya Nadella. Okay, Sundar Khan, Sundar Pichai and Satya Nadella. The correct option is option B, Sundar Pichai. Okay, so next question is, which among the following was declared as the first digital state? I'm repeating the question. Which of the following was declared as the first digital state? Your options are Kerala, Maharashtra, Delhi and Tamil Nadu. I'm repeating the options. Kerala, Maharashtra, Delhi and Tamil Nadu. And the correct answer is option A, Kerala. Okay, Kerala was declared as the first state which is digitalized, that is first digital state. Okay, coming to next question, what is the full form of ATM? What is the full form of ATM? Okay, options are all time money, all time machine, automated teller machine. I'm repeating the question. All time money, all time machine, automated teller machine. And the correct option is automated teller machine. Okay, so next question is, black box in the plane is of which color? Options are white, black, yellow, orange. I'm repeating the options. black box in plane is of which color? So don't use the logic as black box, okay? It's just confusing thing. Black box in plane is of which color? Options are white, black, yellow, orange, and the correct answer is D, orange. Okay. State Assembly elections 2017 is not held in which of the following states? I'm repeating the question. State Assembly elections 2017 is not held in which of the following states? Options are Himachal Pradesh, Punjab, Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh. I'm repeating the options. Himachal Pradesh, Punjab, Uttarakhand, and Uttar Pradesh. And the correct answer is option A, Himachal Pradesh. Like State Assembly elections 2017 is not held in Himachal Pradesh. Okay. So, next question. Out of which of these following products of tobacco have high levels of nicotine? Out of these, which products there is the high content and high level of nicotine? Options are BD, cigars, hookah, and cigarette. Repeating the options, BD, cigars, hookah, and cigarettes. And the correct answer is option A, BD. That is, BD contains high levels of nicotine. Okay. So coming to next question. Who among the following received the 46th Dada Saheb Phalke Award in the year 2015? I'm repeating the question. Who among the following received the 46th Dada Saheb Phalke Award in the year 2015? Options are Rishi Kapoor, Shashi Kapoor, Randhir Kapoor, Shammi Kapoor. I'm repeating the options. Rishi Kapoor, Shashi Kapoor, Randhir Kapoor, and Shammi Kapoor. And the correct answer is option B, Shashi Kapoor. Okay, so Shashi Kapoor received the 46th Dada Saheb Phalke Award in the year 2015. Okay, so coming to next question. When is the next Summer Olympics to be held in 2019? I think this question is wrong. I think they kept when instead of where. So the correct question is, where is the next Summer Olympics to be held in 2019? Because when means year, they already gave you year. So I think the correct question is, where is the next Summer Olympics to be held in 2020? And the correct op like the four options are Beijing, China, Tokyo, Japan, Budapest, Hungary. These are the three options, and the fourth option is Africa, South Korea. I'm repeating the options: Beijing, China, Tokyo, Japan, Africa, South Korea, Budapest, Hungary. And the correct option is option B, which is Tokyo and Japan. So in 2020, the next Summer Olympics is being like is going to be conducted at Tokyo and Japan. Okay, so coming to the next question. The chairman of Lodha Committee of MCI was appointed by whom? The chairman of Lodha Committee of MCI was appointed by whom? Options are Supreme Court, President, Prime Minister. Like, tell me the correct answer. Among, like, what is the correct answer? Whether it is Supreme Court, whether it is President, or whether it is by Prime Minister. And the correct answer is option A, which is Supreme Court. Like, the chairman of Lodha Committee of MCI will be appointed or was appointed by Supreme Court. Okay, so coming to next question. Which among the following parliament became the first world to run on sun power? Which among the following parliament became the first in the world to run on solar power? Okay, so the options are Indian Parliament, Pakistan Parliament, Nepal Parliament, and Parliament of Bangladesh. Okay, these are the four options. I'm repeating the options: Indian Parliament, Pakistan Parliament, Parliament of Nepal, and Parliament of Bangladesh. Okay, the correct answer is option B, Pakistan Parliament. Okay, the Pakistan Parliament is the first parliament in the world which runs on the solar power. Okay, so the next question is, what is the main aim of Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana? What is the main aim of Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana? Options are to provide skill training to youth, to promote art and craft, to ensure the development of infrastructure, to provide the job facilities to the youth. Okay, so these are the four options given. So let's see once again, let's see the options once again. To provide skill training to the youth, to promote the art and craft, to ensure the development of infrastructure, to provide the job facilities to the youth. And the correct option is, the main aim of Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana is to provide the skill training to the youth. Okay, so coming to next question, which is the hottest planet of solar system? I'm repeating the question. Which is the hottest planet of solar system? Options are Mercury, Venus, Jupiter, and Saturn. Okay, I'm repeating the options: Mercury, Venus, Jupiter, and Saturn. And the correct answer is Venus. Venus is the hottest planet of the entire solar system. Okay, so coming to next question, which one of the following zones of the atmosphere is rich in ozone gas? Which one of the following zones of the atmosphere is rich in ozone gas? Options are mesosphere, troposphere, stratosphere, and ionosphere. I'm repeating the option: mesosphere, troposphere, stratosphere, and ionosphere. And the correct answer is stratosphere. Okay, stratosphere is one of the zone of the atmosphere which has rich ozone gas. Okay, and the next option is, next question is, select one of the odd legs. Odd one we need to select out of these four options, like the four options which I give to you. Out of those four, which is the odd option, you have to select and pick it. Okay, the options are cricket, table tennis, badminton, football. I'm repeating the option: cricket, table tennis, badminton, and the football. Option C is correct answer, badminton. Okay, next question and the final GK question is this, and after this we'll go through the last 6 months current affairs. Okay, so the final question in GK is, Supreme Court judge retires upon attaining the age of dash. Options are 65 years, 66 years, 60 years, 55 years. So these are the four options given. Supreme Court judge retires after the attaining of a particular age. What is that age? That is 65 years, 60 years, 55 years, and 66 years. And the correct answer is 65 years. After attaining 65 years, the Supreme Court judge needs to retire. Okay, so now let's go through the current affairs. Last 6 months current affairs. So let's begin with November 2018 current affairs. So coming to November 2018 current affairs. So first let's see who are the persons appointed in what posts in November 2018. So let's begin. First is Arvind Saxena has been appointed as chairman of UPSC. Okay, so Arvind Saxena in 2018 of November has been appointed as a chairman of Union Public Service Commission. So this is one of the important and most important point which may appear into your exam, competitive exam. So make sure you remember this point. And next is A.M. Nayak has been appointed as chairman of National Skill Development Corporation. Okay, so A.M. Nayak has been appointed as chairman of National Skill Development Corporation, which is also called NSDC. Okay, so next is Bank of International Settlements appointed Siddharth Tiwari as chief representative for Asia and Pacific. Okay, so Bank of International Settlements, that is BIS, appointed Siddharth Tiwari as chief representative for Asia and Pacific. Okay, so government appointed UIDAI CEO Ajay Bhushan Pandey as new revenue secretary in 2018 November, and also Sumanta Chaudhary is appointed as new coal secretary. Okay, Sumanta Chaudhary has been appointed as new coal secretary. Okay, so the new Chief Justice of Tripura is, like, the new Chief Justice of Tripura High Court is Sanjay Karol. Okay, remember this. The new Chief Justice of Tripura High Court is Sanjay Karol, and the new Chief Justice for Bihar High Court is Amreshwar Pratap Sahi. Okay, Amreshwar Pratap Sahi. And coming to Madhya Pradesh, Chief Justice is for the High Court of Madhya Pradesh is S.K. Seth. Okay, and coming to Chief Justice of High Court for Uttar Pradesh is Govind Mathur. Okay, Govind Mathur. So RRB Bank appointed Vikas Muthu as Chief Executive Officer of its subsidiary Swadhar Finserv. Okay, and now let's discuss about what awards has been awarded to different people, okay, in 2018 of November. Okay, let's see. So A.N. Patil named as recipient of Kunchakala Tapasvi Lifetime Achievement Award by Chitrakala Silpi D.V. Halbavi National Memorial Trust. Okay, I'm repeating the point. A.N. Patil named as recipient of Kunchakala Tejasvi Lifetime Achievement Award by Chitrakala Silpi D.V. Halbavi National Memorial Trust of Karnataka. Okay, so next is in 2018 November, US President Medal of Freedom has been given to different individuals, that is for music, Elvis Presley, for baseball, Babe Ruth, for S.C. Judge, Antonin Scalia, and for baseball, as I already said, it's Babe Ruth. Okay, for music, music point is very important. For music, it is Elvis Presley. Okay, so in Asia's Pacific Screen Award 2018, best performance by an actor won to be India's Nawazuddin Siddiq for Manto. Okay, so best performance by the actor male won to India's Nawazuddin Siddiq for Manto. Okay, and coming to Punjab Police, Punjab Police won Crime and Criminal Tracking Network System for Good Practice Award for Development of Digital Criminal Intelligence. Okay, they have launched this digital thing, so they have been recognized for, like, you know, they won Crime and Criminal Tracking Network and Systems, and they Good Practice Award for the Development of Digital Criminal Intelligence and Generation of State Crime Record Bureau Reports. Okay, so Baba Kalyani led committee tasked to study existing SEZ policy, that is said policy of India, submitted its report to Commerce Minister, Suresh Prabhu. Okay, so Baba Kalyani led committee tasked to study existing SEZ policy of India submitted its report to Commerce Minister Suresh Prabhu. Okay, and now coming to the important dates in November 2018. November 1st is the foundation day of 7 Indian states, that is Karnataka, Kerala, Lakshadweep, Chhattisgarh, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and Haryana. So it is a foundation day for these 7 states, that is, I'm repeating, November 1st is the foundation day for 7 different states, and the 7 different states are Karnataka, Kerala, Chhattisgarh, Punjab, Rajasthan, Haryana and Madhya Pradesh. And coming to November 2nd is the international day to end impunity for crimes against journalists. Okay, it is the international day to end impunity for crimes against journalists. Okay, and November 7th is the National Cancer Awareness Day. Okay, November 7th is the National Cancer Awareness Day. And coming to November 9th is the National Legal Services Day. Okay, so it is also called as NLSD, National Legal Services Day. And coming to November 10th is World Science Day for Peace and Development. Okay, World Science Day for Peace and Development. Okay, and coming to November 11th, it is National Educational Day in India. Okay, it is the National Educational Day in India. Okay, so coming to November 14th, as we all know, it is the Children's Day celebrated in India. And coming to November 14th, it is also known as World's Diabetes Day. Okay, November 14th, as far as we know, it is just a Children's Day. No, it's not only Children's Day, it is also celebrated as World's Diabetes Day. Okay, and coming to November 15th, it is Jharkhand Statehood Day. Okay, so it is Jharkhand Statehood Day. Okay, and coming to November 16th, it is National Press Day. November 17th is International Students Day. November 19th is International Men's Day. November 19th is also National Integration Day in India. And November 19th is also World's Toilet Day. November 20 is Universal Children's Day. And also African Industrialization Day. And coming to November 21st, it is World's Fisheries Day as well as World's Television Day. And coming to November 25th, it is International Day for Elimination of Violence Against Women. Okay, so coming to November 26th, it is Indian Constitution Day. And November 29th is UN International Day. So these are the important days in November. And so now let's see what all the things happened in December 2018. So current affairs related to 2018 of December. So first thing is Andres Manuel Lopez Obrador has been appointed as president of Mexico for 6 years. I'm repeating, Andres Manuel Lopez Obrador has been appointed as president of Mexico for how many years? For 6 years. Okay, next is Andre won presidential elections of Madagascar, which is East Africa. Okay, so Atul Sahai has been appointed as chairman and managing director of PSU National New India Assurance. Okay, I'm repeating, Atul Sahai has been appointed as chairman as well as the managing director of PSU New India Assurance. Okay, so BVP Rao elected as president of Archery Association of India. This is also one of the important questions. Remember it. BVP Rao elected as president of Archery Association of India. Okay. And CA Kuttappa appointed as India's chief boxing coach. Okay. I'm repeating. CA Kuttappa appointed as India's chief boxing coach. Okay. And so coming to the awards, actress Janhvi Kapoor was awarded as Rising Talent by Norwegian Consulate General in Mumbai. Okay, so actress Janhvi Kapoor was awarded as the Rising Talent in the honor in Mumbai. And actress Sonam Kapoor named by people for the ethical treatment of animals as India's Person of the Year 2018. Okay, so Sonam Kapoor has been awarded with the name as India's Person of the Year of 2018. And Lifetime Achievement Award has been taken by Rajya Sabha MP Sharad Pawar and Murali Manohar Joshi. I'm repeating, Lifetime Achievement Achievement Award is being taken by Rajya Sabha MP Sharad Pawar and Murali Manohar Joshi. And Best Parliamentarian Award is being taken by Ghulam Nabi Azad as well as Nishikant Dubey. Okay, Best Parliamentarian Award is being taken by Ghulam Nabi Azad as well as Nishikant Dubey. And Best Debut Women of Parliamentarian of Lok Sabha is Hema Malini. And and what all things, like these are the Star Screen Awards in which was given in December 2018. So Best Actor is Ranveer Singh for Padmavat. Best Actress is Alia Bhatt for Razi. Best Film is Three, and best director is Sriram Raghavan for Andhadham and all the related things, and few books or has also been released. That is a book of Rural Manifesto and few other books. And coming to the most important days in December are December 2nd is the International Day for Abolition of Slavery, and December 3rd is the International Day for Persons for with Disabilities, and December 4th is Indian Navy Day, December 7th is Armed Forced Flag Day, and December 11th is International Mountain Day. December 12th is Universal Health Coverage Day, and coming to December 20, it is International Human Solidarity Day, and coming to 2022 of December, it is National Mathematics Day in India, and coming to December 23rd, it is the most important day for us. It is National Farmers Day. Without them, we can't sustain. And December 5th is World Soil Day. So these are the few important days as of December 2018. So now let's go through few important events, few important appointments, awards, as well as few important days in 2019 of January. So let's begin our video. AK Sikri appointed as Executive Chairman of National Legal Services Authority. I'm repeating. AK Sikri appointed as Executive Chairman of National Legal Services Authority, and Amitabh Chaudhary took the charge as Managing Director and CEO of Axis Bank. Like, such kind of questions will be frequently asked, so make sure you remember them. And Dilip Sadarangani has been appointed as part-time chairman of Federal Bank. And another more important question is, government appointed Kumar Rajesh Chandra as Director General in Sahasrasima Bal, SSB, okay? And Hemant Bhargava is being appointed as Acting Chairman of Life Insurance Corporation of India, okay? And coming to next question. In 2018, these are the ICC awards. The Cricketer of the Year has been won by Virat Kohli. Test Player of the Year has been won by Virat Kohli, and ODI Player of the Year won by Virat Kohli, and Emerging Player of the Year was been won by Rishabh Pant, belonging to India. And Associated Player of the Year is by Calcom MacLeod, Calcom, Calcom MacLeod, MacLeod. Okay, he is the person from Scotland. And Umpire of the Year is being won by Kumar Dharmasena, who belongs to Sri Lanka, and few other awards. And coming to movies, best motion picture is Green Book, as well as Bohem Rhapsody. And best performer in the motion picture is actor, coming to actor, Rami Malek. And coming to actress, Glenn Close. So few other awards. And coming to industrial awards, IIT Roorkee Professor Jayanta Kumar, has been conferred as National Geospatial Award for Excellence. Okay, and Godrej Group Chairman Adi Godrej conferred Lifetime ICSI Lifetime Achievement Award. And best novel is been Nirish Varan by Malayalam novelist V.J. James, and best poetry is Mindaprani by Veeran Kutty. Best short film is by Aymanan John. Biography is by Jayachandran Mokeri. And coming to the Padmashri is been awarded to Rajeshwar Acharya for the art vocal Hindustani, and it is also been awarded to few more people. And coming to Padma Bhushan, it is for John Chambers for trade and industry and technology. It is also been awarded to Kadia Munna for public affairs of the state Jharkhand, and Praveen Gordhan for public affairs of South Africa, and few more awards. So now let's see few important days of January. January 4th is the first UN World Braille Day, and January 10th is the World Hindi Day. January 12th is the National Youth Day in India. January 14th is Armed Force Veterans Day, and January 15th is the Indian Army Day. Coming to January 24th is the International Day of Education. January 24th is also National Girl Child Day, and coming to January 25th, it is National Otters Day in India. And coming to January 26th, it is Republic Day in India, and it is also the International Customs Day. Coming to January 27th, it is International Remembrance Day, and January 30 is the World's Leprosy Eradication Day. And so these are the few very most important things which mostly repeat in all the competitive exams. So let's now discuss about current affairs of February 2019. So let's begin our video. Bhushan Sharan Singh is being elected as President of Wrestling Federation of India for his third term, and the government appointed Rishi Kumar Shukla as new Director of CBI. CBI stands for Central Bureau of Investigation. And Egypt's President Abdel Fattah El-Sisi has been appointed as the chairman of the African Union during summit of Ethiopia. And coming to the awards, Album of the Year is by the winner of the Album of the Year is Golden Harbor by Cassie Musgraves, and Record of the Year has gone through This Is America, Childish Gambino. And best new artist is Dua Lipa, and best tramp album is Invasion of Privacy by Cardi B, and few more. And coming to best director is Alfonso Cuarón, and best film is Roma, and few more awards related to movies. And best mobile app is Ecode Services, Ecode Services, T App Folio, mobile Miseva app Andhra Pradesh, and emerging technology is Rajkot Highway project, and crop area estimation and loss assessment for the state of Gujarat. Football Delhi presented the first ever Football Ratna award to be noted for the Indian footballer Sunil Chhetri. Okay, and now let's see the most important days for February. February 2nd is the World's Wetlands Day. February 4th is the World Cancer Day. And February 10th is the first ever UN World Pulses Day. And February 11th is the International Day of Women and Girls in Science. Okay. And coming to February 13th, it is UNESCO World Radio Day. And coming to February 20, it is World Day for Social Justice. And World NGO Day is February 27. So now let's see the current affairs of March 2019. In March 2019, A.K. Mohanty appointed as director in Bhabha Atomic Research Center, and Aditya Kumar Misra has been appointed as new chairman for the Agricultural Scientific Recruitment Board. And best film is Raji. And the books which were released are books of Indian Fiscal Federalism, written by Y.V. Reddy, and few more books which have released was Man Ki Baat and Every Vote Counts and The Great Disappointed, How Narendra Modi, like all the stuff, that is one of the book. And coming to the important days in March, March 21st is the International Day of Forests, and March 8th is the International Women's Day, March 1st is the Zero Discrimination Day, and coming to March 12th, it is the day of Dandi Satyagraha or Sal Satyagraha. And coming to March 15th, it is the World's Consumers' Right Day, and excuse me, I'll just adjust the light and come. Yes, I hope I'm visible better now. Yeah, so coming to next question. On March 22nd, it is the most important day for us. It is the World's Water Day. And March 27th is the World's Theatre Day. And March 4th is the National Security Day in India. Okay. Coming to defense, India's Border Security Force and the Border Guards, Bangladesh, concluded Main Mati Matri Joint Exercise 2019. Okay, and the largest war game of Indian Navy was a part of March RBI has put penalty of rupees 2 crore on Punjab National Bank for non-compliance of regularity directions with regard of SWIFT operations. Okay, and now let's go to the current affairs of 2019 April. So AIFF President Praful Patel being the first Indian to be elected as a member of FIFA Executive Council for a 4-period time, and Bibhu Kalyan Nayak became the first Indian to be appointed as Chair of International Hockey Federation, and coming to awards, UNESCO awarded to reporters. Okay, UNESCO has been awarded to reporters for in reporting on alleged human rights violations. And coming to Lifetime Contribution Award is being awarded to Azim H. Premji, and Azim H. Premji is the chairman of Wipro Limited. And coming to outstanding institution builder is being awarded to Pratap C. Reddy, who is the founder and chairman of Apollo Hospitals. And Entrepreneur of the Year award has been gone to Sanjeev Bajaj, who was the managing director of Bajaj Finserv Limited. And coming to Indian MNC of the Year is been gone to Pawan for Mahindra Limited. And coming to Director of the Year, it is for Rajkumar. And coming to sports, the Sports Person Award of the Year male is for Neeraj Chopra for athletics, and for Sports Person of the Year female is for badminton, who was PV Sindhu. And comeback of the year is Saina Nehwal for badminton, and coach of the year is Jaspal Rana for shooting. And emerging sports person of the year is Saurabh Chaudhary for shooting. And lifetime achievement of award is for Pradeep Kumar Banerjee for football. And differently able athlete of the year is Ekta Bhyan for para athletics. Okay, so coming to the Indian awards, Tata Steel has been named as Global Slag Company of the Year. And the questions which I'm discussing is the most important questions. It doesn't mean that these are the only things or the only current affairs which happened in that particular month. It's not like that. These are the most important current affair questions which will frequently repeat. So that's why I'm repeating this. Okay, because if I have to read a point to point, the time doesn't the time will not be sufficient. So I'm just repeating the most important points. So coming to books, a biography of Indian diplomat and politician is one of the book which was been released. And another books which was released by was Seigel's Life and Music, Politics of Jugaad, and some few more books. And coming to the most important days in April are: April 1st is the foundation day of RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India. And April 10th is the World's Homeopathy Day. April 11th is the National Safe Motherhood Day. April 11th is also World's Parkinson's Day. And April 12th is the International Day for the Human Space Flight. And April 13th is the 100th anniversary of Jallianwala Bagh. And April 19th was the Good Friday. April 23rd was the was the day where it was known as Konginam War, and April 25th was the World's Malaria Day. April 26th was the World's Intellectual Property Day, and April 29th was 28th was World's Day for Safety and Health at Work, and April 30 was the International Jazz Day, JAZZ. Okay, so these are the few more important things which you need to remember, which occurred. Like, these are the current affairs which happened in 2019 April. So now let's see May current affairs. Okay, so Facebook released maps, and an AI model was developed for the lung cancer detection. Like, in order to detect the lung cancer, artificial intelligence has been used, and there was a model developed on 21st May 2019, that is yesterday. And bank credit to infrastructure grew to 18.5%, and Facebook registered a new cryptocurrency firm recently, that is yesterday. And yesterday was the anti-terrorism day, that is 21st May was like is the anti-terrorism day. And ISRO announced 7 missions for the next 10 days, and PCT Humanity entered the Guinness World's Record because it was a charity which was run by an Indian, and it got recognized recently, and it was entered into the Guinness World's Records. And Sri Lanka marked 10 years to the civil war. So these are the few most important. And Lok Sabha polls at 67.10%. So these are the few current affairs, like the most important current affairs since last 6 to 7 months. So I hope you found this video useful. Thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos, and share this video, like this video if you really love this video, and share this video with all your friends. And if you want to watch more and more such kind of useful videos, you know what to do. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon for more such videos. And subscription is absolutely free, so feel free to subscribe to my channel. And I hope you do well in your exams. All the very best for your all the competitive exams, and especially AIIMS is going to start within 2 to 3 days. So all the best for you all. Keep preparing well. And also refer to previous papers, so it will be useful for you also. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching this video, and please subscribe to my channel and like and share this video. Thanks for watching.